faith, believing God the way God said it. Believe God. One day God appeared to Abraham. He said, Abraham, leave your country, leave your father's house, leave your kindred. Genesis chapter 2, verse 1, 2, and 3. In verse 4, the Bible says, and Abraham departed. Whatever God told him, he will do. That's faith in God. He so believed God. They say, Abraham, why will you go and kill a child you waited for 25 days? Now, Hebrew, I believe it's Hebrew chapter 12. He tells us that Abraham believed that if God asked him to kill Isaac and he killed Isaac, God is able to raise Isaac up again. That's faith. What God requires from us is faith. Let somebody read for me Matthew chapter 12 from verse 1. Look at the accusation they gave to Jesus.
At that time, Jesus went on the Sabbath day through the corn.
Now, I want us to pay attention to this. It was on the Sabbath day, Abby. Yes. And Jesus was going through, what do you call it now? A forest of corn. Huh? A plantation of corn. God bless you. And there was a path that Jesus and his disciples needed to walk through, but it was on the Sabbath day. And on the Sabbath day, you don't walk according to their law. Yes, sir.
And his disciples were hungry.
And they were hungry. So they should have remained starving. Because it was a Sabbath day, they shouldn't have eaten. Yes, sir.
And began to pluck the ears of corn and to eat.
Now you will see what I want to bring out. Righteousness by faith and righteousness by the works of the law.
But when the Pharisees saw it.
When the Pharisees. The leaders in the temple, those ones who are the custodian and the preservers of the law, when they saw it, today's another day, they are plucking corn. You don't know you are not supposed to pluck corn. You should hunger and die because it's a Sabbath day. You don't walk. They started accusing Jesus. Yes, sir.
They said to him, behold, thy disciples do that which is not lawful to do upon the Sabbath day.
They are doing what is not lawful. They are mindful of the law. They are not mindful of grace. They are not mindful. If God told them something, and say God told them, they had the word of God, and it runs contrary to the law that Moses brought, I tell you, they would rather prefer what Moses said to. They prefer Moses to God. If they did not prefer Moses to God, do you know that Jesus told them that the one who is greater than Solomon is here? Because they believe Solomon is the greatest of all men. Huh? And the one greater than Solomon is here. They are still reporting his disciples to him. Yes, sir.
But he said unto them,
Jesus said to them,
have ye not read what David did?
Have you not read how David entered the temple and ate the showbread in the altar that is meant for priests? Not even he was not a priest. David was not a priest. David was a king. Yes, sir.
When he was hungry, and they that were with him, how he entered into the house of God.
How David entered into the house of God
and did eat the showbread.
He ate the showbread,
which was not lawful for him to eat.
It was not lawful for him to eat it.
Neither for them which were with him.
Or for them, the soldiers that were with him. Because David, if you read that thing in 2 Samuel, David was actually coming from a war. He has gone for battle for many months, many days, many weeks, and he's now coming back, he's hungry. How many of us know that the church is our father's house? Then he got into his father's house. I mean, I cannot imagine my children now. Like, my children went to school, they are in boarding house. Now school vacated and they came in. And I know one of them that is very naughty. And he goes straight into the fridge, opens it, and he saw a juice and he picked that juice. And imagine a father saying, why did you pick that juice? Do you know that this juice we don't have to drink it until Sunday? Yeah, because it's for so end. You know the way that child will look at the father. He may not eat, she or she may not talk. But Omar registers a memory, this one is a wicked man. Omoti because there is no how they take care of you in school compared to Ile. That joy that I'm going home. Of you daily, we want to you say Elizabeth on Sunday. What everybody back up before Sunday? God forbid. That's exactly what they were telling Jesus. So Jesus said, David went to battle. Now he's coming back, but now to his soldiers and they are hungry. And you are saying you shouldn't get into his father's house. God does not even care about all those. What God cares about is your present future, your work with your relationship with him. Yes, sir.
But only for the priest.
Yes.
Or have you not read in the law?
Yes.
How that on the Sabbath days the priest in the temple profane the Sabbath and are blameless.
Continue, sir.
But I say unto you, that in this place is one greater than the temple.
He says, in this place, me, Jesus, you are looking at. Anyway, I won't believe Jesus, you know. You are not like that. I know you believe in Jesus. Don't you? He said, the one that is greater than the temple, and that your law, Moses' law, you are quoting. He said, that one is here. Yes, sir.
But if he had known what this meaneth,
yes,
I will have mercy and not sacrifice.
Thank you.
You would not have condemned the guiltless.
You would not have condemned the guiltless. If you know me as God of mercy. Okay, assuming Babot Ejeshen. Assuming be Sheni, what Sheni Sabbath? Eh? I'm God of mercy. I mercy them, I pity them, I forgive them. Shut up. He holds the ace, A-C-E. He holds the joker. The whole world can condemn you as a child of God. If God doesn't condemn you, they are wasting their time. And I'm robber. Thank you, sir. And I'm robber that has been killing many people, collecting people's goods. And on the day he was to be executed on the right hand of Jesus, Jesus said, today with me, you will end up in paradise. It's because he's God of mercy. He can do and undo anything. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He holds the authority, the power. Everything begins and ends with him. That's why he is the almighty. There are many mighty men. There is only one almighty God. That is the God we serve. Once we know him, we will walk with him. What God desires from me and you, and you will see it in the life of these three people we are going to look at. What he expects of us is to walk with him. W-A-L-K. Walk with him. Walking with God is the same thing as having faith in him or believing in him. Walking with God is whatever he tells you to do, do it. According to Mary, what Mary told the disciples of Jesus in John chapter 2 verse 5. He said, whatever this man tells you to do, when you do it, is the same thing as walking with him. And when you walk with him, your story must change.
Amen.
When you walk with this God, you know what God told Abraham? God told Abraham, Abraham, look, of everything else, walk with me. Because it is in your walking with me, you become perfect. Genesis chapter 17, Abraham verse 1 and 2. He said, walk with you. God told Abraham, walk with me. When you walk with me on a daily basis, it will lead to your perfection.
And when Abraham was 90 years old.
Yes.
And 9.
Yes.
The Lord appeared to Abraham.
The Lord appeared to Abraham.
And said unto him.
And said to Abraham.
I am the Almighty God.
I am the Almighty God.
Walk before me.
Walk with me. And our Romans don't translate when we're going, but you know they are not English people. So they meant to say, walk with me. They now say, walk before me. So I'm correcting them. Hallelujah.
And be thou perfect.
If you walk with me, I say, go this way, you go. Go this way, you go. Thank you, man. God begins to see you as a perfect person. It is not about not having error. Error is different from living inside sin. Every man born of man and woman must make error. You are not God. It's only God that is error free. But when you make error, you quickly correct it and you move on. God likes that one. If you look at David, each time David commits sin, David never goes back to the same sin. That's what is called error. But the sin you commit again and again and again and again, yet the baraku. That one is deliberate. That's not a contrite heart. There is no brokenness in that. The righteousness by faith that God is talking about is walking with Him. If God says, worship me, that's all I want you to do, and you keep at it, that's walking with God by faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Look at Enoch, for example, in Genesis chapter 5. Let's look at Enoch. The Bible says he walked with God. Enoch chapter 5, verse 24.
And Enoch walked with God,
mm-hmm.
and
he
was not.
Yes.
For God took him.
Continue.
And Methuselah lived 187 years.
Yes.
And begat Lamech. And Methuselah lived after he begat Lamech 782 years, and begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Methuselah were 969 years.
I'm coming. Yes, verse 22 and 24.
And Enoch walked with God.
Yes.
And he begat Methuselah.
Yes.
300 years.
Mm-hmm.
And begat sons and daughters. And all the days of Enoch were 365 years.
Okay.
And Enoch walked with God, and it was not, for God took him.
Okay. Now go to Hebrews 11 verse 5, talking about the same Enoch. The reason, we want to look at the reason. Now he walked with God, yes. Look at the reason again.
By faith.
By faith.
Enoch was translated.
He was translated.
That he should not see death.
That he should not die as normal man, yes.
And was not found.
He was not found.
Because God had translated him.
Yes.
For before his translation.
Before God took him.
He had his testimony.
He had this testimony.
That he pleased God.
Thank you, ma'am. What was it that he did?
He walked
with God. So walking with God pleases God. And sure, you know that the Bible says without faith we cannot please God. Hebrews 11:6. Without faith we cannot please God.
Without faith,
mm-hmm.
It is impossible to please him.
Thank you, ma'am. That's it. For without faith it is impossible to please. Now, and the Bible says Enoch pleased God. By how?
By having faith.
Now what is how did he show that he had faith in God? He was walking with God. So walking with God is pleasing God. And when you please God, that is having faith in him. Do we understand it now?
Yes.
When we please God, how do you please God? Whatever he tells you to do, do. Whatever he tells you don't do, don't do. It doesn't matter who is angry. They will say, Tieti, Podu, show me corny. Is that what God said? If it is what God said, you do. If it's what God did not say, don't do it. If you do what God did not say, you won't get result now. A big man, army general from Syria, he came to Jerusalem to see a prophet. And the prophet did not come out. The prophet said, my friend, go and tell that general outside. They call him Naaman. Go and tell him to go and dip himself in Jordan. That is what the word of God has said. 7 times. So if he goes to Jordan River and do it 6 times and a half, he will not get results. That is not walking with God. Walking with God is doing it exactly as God said it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Look at Noah, Genesis 6. Walking with God. Genesis 6, verse 9, 11, and 12.
These are the generations of Noah.
These are the generation of Noah.
Noah was a just man.
The Bible says he was a just man. Not that Noah, as a human being, did not have errors. You want to ask me, how did I know? The same Noah, after the flood, he came out. Oh, Shekini.
He got drunk.
Not that there was no error in his life. What differentiates Noah from the people of his generation is whatever Tonobani Kosholo Maji. And to that is righteousness. Righteousness, the definition of righteousness is right standing with God. If God says,